If you've been on the internet for long, you will notice that everyone has opinions. Some of these are good opinions, like those involving pineapple on pizza. Others are bad opinions, like anything related to politics on Twitter. And when you get into the anime community, you will find no shortage of bad opinions. See r/anime. So today, let's celebrate these bad opinions, specifically my top 10 bad anime opinions. Oh yeah, let's do this. Let's start off with a classic that is Sword Art Online. Now, you're probably one of two types of people here. You could be one of those SEO fans who are ready for me to defend the show and talk about why Kirito is the best waifu of all time. Or you're one of the haters, ready for me to talk about why Kirito and SAO are the worst anime and main character of all time. Well, turns out, neither of those are true for me. And in fact, my opinion is that SAO is average. It has some really fascinating science fiction storytelling, especially when it ponders what life could be like when VR becomes prevalent in the future. And it also speaks to the power of video games and how they can connect people together. This combined with some great action makes it a really fun and fascinating series. But then there are other times in the show where it's boring or makes no sense or is super predictable. And times when they have Kirito as the focus when he's not the good part of the show. So with so much to like, so much to dislike, I can think of no other word than average to fit SAO. Alright. Let's now move on to the beloved show, Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid. I dropped this one after 3 episodes, because it was boring. Well, not boring so much as characters being annoying. And this is one of the issues I have with Kyo Annie anime as a whole. The characters are so aggravating at first, and that's how I felt with this one. Any show for me to like it needs to give me a character to connect to want to root for. But here we have Toru, who is annoying and randomly shows up and throws herself into Kobayashi's life. I have trouble pronouncing that name, by the way. And then there's this big battle in episode 3 that my friend said was super amazing. And it looked cool, but it was boring. There's no point to it. I didn't care about the characters. There are no stakes. It was just flashy for the sake of being flashy, which, yeah, it looked nice. But there was no substance there. And, yeah, I probably would not complain so much if it wasn't a show that everyone likes, but when everyone likes it and then I don't, I feel like I need to get my opinion out there. And when this is a video for bad anime opinions, well, what better time to get my opinions out there for that? And yeah, I'm being very vague with this one, but it's been so long since I saw it, and I don't want to rewatch it just to make the video, so here, that's my stance. That's one beloved show I've talked about. Let's move on from that. Instead of talking about one show for my third entry, let's talk about a whole decade, the 1990s. There are a lot of well-loved shows from the 90s. And after trying a lot of them, they are far duller than their reputation would have led me to believe. And these shows definitely have interesting aspects to them, don't get me wrong. But it takes forever to get to the interesting parts so that once I do get to them, I just don't care. Like Berserk. It had a first episode that made no sense out of context. It was a terrible introduction. And then the plot started to pick up. Very slowly. It was so slow to get started that by the time I got to the big battles, I just didn't care. They felt dull and predictable. And I was like, I could be watching so many other things I'd enjoy more. Then this was the same with Trigun. There are some really fascinating aspects to the show with Vash and his background and where he came from and his mindset and what he's trying to do. But it took half the show for the story to actually kick in. So while I do appreciate it from a conceptual level, I ended up losing interest by the time it was supposed to get good so that when there were those good parts, I just didn't care. And then Cowboy Bebopp was similar here. The plot-focused episodes being like a quarter of the show, and many of the other episodes felt pointless. Nothing changed because of them. And then there's Evangelion, which I actually do generally like that one, and I find it to be a step above the others, since while most of the show was episodic, it felt like there's a clear progression, either with the plot or the character development in every episode. Or just the whole mystery of the world, too. Though I find it hard to give too much praise for a show where I have to go read the Wikipedia article after every episode to know what I just saw. Yeah, this video is going to have an interesting like to dislike ratio. And speaking of interesting, let us now move on to Fate. The Fate Stay Night franchise is indeed one of my favorites. But you know what I like even more than Fate Stay Night? Fate Kaleid, Prisma Ilia. I've talked about this before, but I really do love Fate Kaleid. Fates Day Night and All Three Routes and Fate Zero are very interesting dark fantasy shows that have a ton of fascinating storytelling. But as good as these are, I don't feel that they're anything unique. Other shows also do the same type of storytelling, dark fantasy, suspense, action, all that. But Fate Kaleid is very unique. Kaleid may start off as a fun parody, but it has a lot of very heartwarming moments, along with some of the darkest storytelling seen in Fate. These two opposites blend together to create something special that neither type of storytelling could do on its own. So that is why Fate Kaleid is the best Fate, at least in my opinion, of course. So let's now move on to another one of my favorites, My Hero Acadamia. Now the show is pretty popular, so I don't think me saying it's my favorite anime is a bad opinion, but I think I have something on the show that will be a bad opinion, and that's that Touga is a bad character, and because, well, she is. I don't get her appeal. She is probably one of the least developed villains from the League of Villains, and it seems like the only appeal she has is like she's a villain, but she kind of has some feelings for Deku, maybe. But even then, she hasn't like gotten times to shine. She's just like been there, and yeah, I just don't get what makes her so fascinating. The show has so many amazing characters that I love, both the heroes and some of the villains too. But Touga, not really. Okay, let's now take another step back and talk about a whole genre now, and that is anime comedies, which largely suck. Not all, but most of the popular ones I just find are not funny after the first episode or two. Sure, they might have these hilarious, completely off-the-wall first episodes, but after that point, it's like the show has given me all that it has to offer after those first one or two episodes, and then there is nothing of substance to keep me interested. So that's why I don't care for shows like Nichijo or Daily Lives of High School Boys or Kaguya-sama. And some of the comedies I thought I would love at the start end up falling short, like Zombieland Saga or Grand Blue. To be fair, though, I did like those. They had at least some substance, but felt like they never got back to the highs that they had after the first episode. And so I don't completely bash the genre. There are some comedies that I really do like Konosuba and Golden Boy. But I feel that those are the minority of the very popular comedies that I find just fall short. I would much rather have another genre that has comedy in it when I want to watch something just to laugh at. But do you know which show I do like? Handshakers. Yeah, this one is good. It is a simple enough story, and definitely some of the anime weirdness that could turn people off. But I don't find it's that off-putting compared to all the other weird anime out there. And I legitimately like seeing the characters chase after their wishes, and even more than that, what happens when they have their dreams taken from them. And the art style is where the show gets a lot of hate. But I actually ended up really liking it. It's unique. And yeah, maybe not done the best, but how many other shows out there look like this? It seems like a lot of anime just look very similar. They have the same style. Like, you cannot differentiate one show from the other based on the style. But you can definitely differentiate Handshakers, because there is no other show like it, except for the other weird shows that studio does. And, in addition to this, it led to some really cool AMVs, so there's that. And next we have JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Yeah, this one was a letdown. I really wish I liked it more, and I thought I would like it more. It's an absurd show, and a shonen. Both things I like. But from the first season of JoJo, it just felt lame. Part 1 was a very basic and predictable story, and while I did like it the first couple episodes, after that, it was just completely dull and I lost interest. And part 2 did have a bit more to like with Joseph's whole personality and that fun stuff. But it also was a very basic story with none of the cast beyond Joseph getting a chance to shine, which felt like a real shame. I did enjoy the absurdity of the final battle here, which that was cool. And I feel like if the whole season had been that way, I would have liked it more. But a good final battle does not save a show. And while I have heard that JoJo gets better later on, if I do not see a reason to continue the show after an entire season, then it's failed. Plus, my impression from part 3 is that it is mainly episodic, which makes me not want to try it. If I don't like the first season, and I see no reason I will like the second and third season more, and I need to get past that to get to the good stuff, well, yeah, I don't see what's so good about it. So, yeah, there you go. Maybe I'll just skip part 3 and go on to part 4 at some point. But I feel I've given JoJo enough of my time when I have so many other things I would rather watch. And speaking of things I would rather watch, you know what show is good and absurd? Symphogear. Symphogear is one of the greatest anime I have ever seen. And I would go so far as to say it is the best magical girl anime ever. It really is a representation of magical girl anime growing up, while still keeping the ideals and the appeal that the genre had. Magical girls capture young viewers' hearts, give them characters to believe in, and show them stories where the heroes overcome evil to save the world. That's Symphogear. That's the same thing. Except the stakes are higher, and the world is a place filled with terrible events. But the message is still the same. With the power of each other, it's possible to overcome this evil and grow beyond the tragedies. The battles in Symphogear also capture the excitement that first drew me into anime, and the music is just the icing on the cake to make the show something amazing. I definitely enjoy magical girl shows that venture into dark storytelling, but I like Symphogear even more because of how, while it grows up, it is never abandoning the optimism that the genre is made for. Symphogear is good, and it be the best magical girl anime out there is an opinion I will stick behind. But it is no masterpiece. You know what show is, though? No, not Legend of Galactic Heroes, not FMA. Actually, FMA is, and Legend of Galactic Heroes might be, I just haven't seen it, but they are not the shows I'm talking about right now. No, the show I'm talking about here is gonna be the Twintails. Some may see the show as nothing more than a stupid show, but it's different for me. There's just so much more here. You may think I'm exaggerating, but that's not true at all. The show uses this stupid concept to tell a story about the challenges of growing up and why it is so easy to get lost when following your passions. Soji's story of turning into a magical girl is not something that high school boys typically go through, I think. But his journey and those of his friends is something that I think will be relatable to many. It is something I've never seen explored in anime in such a way. So that is why Twintails is a masterpiece. So which of these bad opinions do you think was the worst? Or are there some that you agree with? Let me know. And remember, these are just my opinions, so I'm immune to any and all criticism. I think that's how it works. But now, if you'll excuse me, since I have had so much fun expressing these opinions, I now need to go discuss with certain family members my choice for the upcoming presidential election. And I will see you soon. Assuming I survive.